Hello and welcome to another episode of What Do You Think, Chris? Well, not everyone can afford to buy in Sydney. Whether you're in the eastern suburbs, Lion or Shore, or in the west, you're kind of talking $750 for a one-bedroom unit, into the millions for a two-bed, and kind of around the one-and-a-half mark for a three-bedroom unit. So what can you do if you can't afford to get into Sydney? Well, what we actually do as a business, as a buyer's agents, we actually go and get some independent research to try and find out where are the next places to buy, where you're not going to drop your trousers if COVID happens and things go bad or we go through another recession or something like that. But also we want a reasonable amount of growth and ideally we'd like a good bit of rent. So this is a property that we actually bought for a client very, very recently at 20 Simpson Court in Mayfield, which is up in Newcastle. Now the client bought it for $570,000, so reasonably affordable for a lot of people that can't afford the Sydney market. And it's rented for $480 a week, which is 4.4%. Now in Sydney, most of the rentals we're getting at the moment are around 3.5%, maybe 4% if we're lucky, but this is around 4.4%. So definitely better if you're someone younger trying to get in the market, having a bit of extra cash flow is great as well. So it's a single level home with casual kind of family living, split air system, four bedrooms, three with built-in. So absolutely enormous property compared to what you're getting in Sydney. And it's got a great backyard for entertaining and a large pergola as well. And in terms of the area around there, really family friendly, lots of local schools and transport. You've also got your backyard, so it's going to be great for young families, retirees, or maybe even investors. Now, the only con here is it could do with the reno, but also that's obviously a positive as well, because then you can add some instant value. So let's have a look at the property here. So it's been sold through Rain and Horn. Okay, here we are. So that's the front of the property, obviously. And as you can see, a very well lived in home. Again, compared to what you normally get in Sydney, most of the Sydney properties are very, very well styled. Obviously, this isn't necessarily happening here. And so this is more the lived in look that you've got to kind of go with. The good old fish tank in the corner there. Again, it's just a completely different style to what we normally see in Sydney. The good old big TV in there, then that's great. But look, as you can see, it's a family home. You've got kids here, they make a mess. And that's what it is, just going back to the bathrooms. Look, nothing too flash or anything like that, but look, it all works. And so you don't need to necessarily spend a fortune. You've got a big area here. You've got a bit of undercover there. You've got your beer fridge there. And no doubt there's the Barbie over there. And yep, we've got a few things there. And as you can see, a bit of lawn area as well. And that's where it is. So look, it just goes to show if you can't afford to get into Sydney, if you need to wait a few months, I'd wait a couple of months. But if it's going to be 6, 12, 18, 24 months, I'd say it's better to get in the market somewhere. So Newcastle isn't the only place we buy, and certainly we buy in Melbourne and Brisbane as well. So if you've got a budget that isn't going to hit Sydney, drop us a line and we can tell you what we can do. Well, thanks for joining us.